E-plate of the Cart Virtual E-plate here at Clay Pigeon. We are currently in just beginning qualifying with Sam Lloyd holding the pace just about over Jake Floyd by 7 thousandths of a second right now.
Hello everybody, I'm here too. It's me, remember again. So currently it's fairly close in top 8 with top 9 now, with Jacob only being about 9 tenths off.
Top 10 within a second, top.
Yep,
top
10
five
in a second now.
Actually, not able to find quite the best lap just yet at all in that.
Because this track's always brought very close racing.
It's a brilliant track for racing, and wow, there we go. The top 3 separated by 11. The top 4 separated by less than 10. The top 3 separated by less than 3 hundredths now. Immensely tight at the top here. Archie Heron, of course, leading the reigning champion, reigning E-plate winner as well. He's firm favourite to win here.
I think Jacob's just trying to put in a good lap because Jacob is quite quick here.
That puts him within half a second as well, top at the moment.
And that was with a bad lap as well.
Yeah, I didn't check it. Actually, I lost we found a little bit more of a gap, but top 4 within a 10th. And Logan Stewart only a little bit over. This is going to be an incredibly tight battle at the top.
This is, I'd imagine today is going to be an incredibly good race. And looks like a very well put together lap for Jacob just watching it.
Brilliant.
And I thought puts him within 2 seconds of top.
Within 2 tenths.
Oh, sorry, 2 tenths, not 2 seconds.
Oh, no. Neither to be fair. Archie Heron brings out a lap there. This is almost 2 tenths faster than anybody. But he gives himself a little bit of breathing room at the top. Nothing major, but major for Sam Lloyd, Jake Floyd, and then what to worry about.
We're about halfway through qualifying now.
Yeah, we can see Floyd goes up to the top. Top really putting the pressure on Archie Heron.
I think I need to take that bet off the road. I think I need to take the bet off Archie Heron now.
already, Bradley Keaton appears less. I'm not 100% sure that name might be.
That name for Bradley Keaton will be either disqualification or a penalty for today.
Yeah.
Remember, all you need is that singular space between your first name and your second name. It's very simple. One step. One
key. It is, of course, like a... It's a frustrating one, but the rules are the rules, unfortunately.
Exactly. I've changed nothing on my profile since the first race of Kart Virtual.
Mine's in all caps, so I forgot to change it from all caps.
Wee.
I always looked really awkward because everyone's like got big lowercases and I'm just all capital. I might get around to changing that at some point.
Sam Lloyd just on a good lap then, just coming at the final corner. He just lost it a little bit.
Is it? Yeah, he's still about 2.5 tenths off.
Ooh, he almost switched back onto the racing line there and almost killed someone. Alright, now we should be able to get going again.
He needs a tenth of a second to at least to put himself in a really good spot here. Nothing incredible, but this pack is... Especially the top runners, Jake Fuller and Archie Heron, who are leading away here.
Sorry, did I say Sam Lloyd? I meant Archie Heron. What did I say, Archie Heron?
Oh, fair enough. Logan Stewart puts Sam Lloyd down as P4 now. So Sam needs to find a little bit of time here. Because they are running the risk of these two, of Jake and Archie, just leading away a bit. Sam Lloyd comes into the pit lane, bury the exit, that's going to be a penalty.
Ooh, that's
I think he crashed into Archie Heron there as well.
Oh, that's not good.
He was next to the pit, so that is definitely going to be brought out. Brought up there. Jake floating in the pits right now, about to change, about to get fuel and maybe a little setup tweak. We'll find out that.
Just looking at Owen Porter for a second. He's running a rather unique setup, where the rear seems to be slammed all the way down, the front seems to be brought all the way up.
He does drive retros quite a lot, Owen, so maybe yeah. It's just something that suits his driving style better.
Exactly, fair enough. Because they're very, very light and twitchy retros.
I don't drive one, to be fair. I've seen them be driven, though. They look fun.
Yeah, they do look awesome.
Yeah.
Of course, Jacob Metcalf, also a retro racer, but just TKM for now.
That is actually having going slowly right now. Jacob Metcalf, I'm assuming was on a lap. Well, comes off the track. Alphonse Kiwi goes up into P3 as well. I missed that. I'm a great commentator.
Yeah, I missed that as well. Oopsie daisy. And people are the highest quality commentators here.
Yeah. Our virtual anyphones are best. Actually, Heron comes on a flying lap. He begins. Hocks up the rear into the first corner, bounces over the curves into the chicane as well. On both curves, a lot of it taken. Hops into the rear again. I don't know what corner this is now.
Just passing Owen Porter on the outside.
Looks a very smooth lap right now as he comes past Jacob Metcalf. Looks like a good lap.
Not good enough, apparently.
Not improved, so he has one lap after this to take Jake Floyd's pole position off him.
He must be pushing now, really trying to get that final tenth in.
This is so important. The battle between Logan Stewart and Sam Lloyd as well, within a hundredth of a second of each other. So it's absolutely everything to play for right now.
Tucking on the straight. That's our new tactic for the circuit. Still not quick enough.
So here we go, Archie Heron, last possible lap to take pole position. Can he do it? Jake Fleur is staying in the pits. So it looks like he's just going to be watching on here. Can Archie Heron find any time here on this final lap to snatch pole position away? It looks like a solid lap again. Hasn't made any mistakes so far.
Riding up on the grass there a little bit.
Very tight line when once the grass gets nicely wide on the final corner.
Very close.
Is it going to be enough?
It's enough. First place.
Archie Heron is on pole position by half a tenth of a second. Brilliant lap right at the death.
Must be absolutely chuffed with that lap.
He can manage to find an absolute miracle.
Is Jacob pulling a bit late?
Animatey, can he get anything? No, he can't. Jacob Metcalf in the pit lane. That is everybody. Everybody's session over. Archie Heron takes pole position in takes pole position at Clay Pigeon by half a tenth over Jake Fluitt.
With an amazing lap as well.
It was outstanding. It was so smooth, so clean. Absolutely. Really. Okay.
Thank you.
Welcome back, everyone. We're just about a minute away from the restart. We're only through our grid. Archie Heron starts on pole, followed by Jake Flores and Jake Flores on the front row. Second row is Alphonse Kiwi and Logan Stewart. Third row is Sam Lloyd and Daniel Adamaiti. Seventh row of Jacob Metcalf and Owen Potter, the two of the owners of the championship in the league. Third row is Jack. Is it third row?
Nah, who knows?
Fifth row is Jack Stewart and Sebastian Grand. Sixth row, Lewis Paynton and Bradley Keaton rounds off the grid here at Clay Pigeon. Lucas Anderson. No, he's not started.
Just so people know, those final three names, Austin Hallmark.
That's me.
And
Bradley Keaton and Frederic Yannick have been disqualified for jump starts already before the race has started. Are we going to have a restart here, or are we just going to keep going? Let's find out.
I think considering it's only two drivers, it will not be a restart.
Yeah, it doesn't seem to be a restart, so we're going to begin the formation lap now. We are underway here for the formation lap. Archie Heron, it was Isaac Phelps last time, who had absolutely outstanding race starts. So let's see how Archie Heron is going to take these starts. So Frederic Yannick and Bradley Keaton have been taken out, so the grid is now Archie Heron, Jake Flew, Alphonse Kiwi, Logan Stewart, Sam Lloyd, Daniel Adamaiti, Jacob Metcalf, Owen Potter, Jack Stewart, and Lewis Paynton. Lewis will be really disappointed with his qualifying, I think, as well. He had really good pace in the races at Wilton Mill, and he was absolutely electrically jumping up the grid.
And he's just bonked it today.
Yeah, he has not enjoyed it, but it might just be due to the pace of this grid. It's not the biggest grid, but it is a grid, nonetheless, that has very high quality drivers.
Exactly. Now, just want to quickly mention for those watching the live stream, the final three names are not racing.
Yeah.
Bit of a mistake joining, but lucky day.
And here we go.
Here they go on the acceleration line. The acceleration line, and away they go. Brilliant start for Archie Heron. Jake Fluitt, good start.
Jake Fluitt's going to go try and walk around the outside. Not going to be able to do that. He's going to stick around there, though. Actually going to now come under pressure. He holds it, though, from Alphonse Kiwi, and he's going to have another little look. He's going to walk around the outside. Nothing there still. Oh, there's a little bit of contact behind him. Jake Metcalf has had. Looks to have run slightly off track there. Nothing major though, and that is.
Ooh.
Is that off track? Is that.
People off in the background.
That's Owen Potter who ran off track there. I believe.
Poor Owen.
Lewis Paynton has managed to get ahead of Jack Stewart as well. Sam Lloyd, right at the back behind Jacob Metcalf, is now going for the move there. Lewis, not able to get it. Jake Flewitt is right. Still the top three. Flewitt, Heron, and Kiwi right with each other still. Still as well, Metcalf under heavy pressure from Sam Lloyd. Further back, fighting for sixth place right now. Metcalf, Lloyd looks a little bit to the inside, can't find any position. That's just staying calm here. Back to the front, Jake Fluitt still not able to find the door. He's going to walk down the inside into turn one, takes the position, and it looks like he has done. Into the chicane, can Archie Heron fight back? No, he can't. And all this contact. Oh, and that's awful. That's terrible news for Jake Floyd. He's dropped right back down behind Logan Stewart now. Daniel, and Archie Heron's run wide as well. So currently the leader is Alphonse Kiwi,
who qualified third, if I'm correct in saying that.
I think it was third. But that is.
Yeah.
That is how quickly a race can change. He was 0.2 down in qualifying because of a bit of contact between the two front drivers there, Floyd and Heron. That has dropped them down to third and fourth behind Logan Stewart. And under pressure.
Now, unless I'm right saying that, unless that is a private paint for Alphonse Kiwi, that might be a penalty for no paint.
Don't think it's too much of an issue. Oh, and that's
not too much of an issue.
That's a push from Jacob Metcalf to get past Sam Lloyd. Jacob puts his hand up. Is he going to let him pass? He does. But Sam Lloyd is. Look to be on a on a charge to catch up to Daniel Adamaiti as well. Which he is now unable to do. He hasn't too much of a gap, and Metcalf half spins, gets passed there by Lewis Payton and Williams. Alphonse, give you
a Ah, there it is. Yeah, sorry. Argenti. Sorry.
Jake Fluitt has managed to get past Logan Stewart. I must have missed that. My apologies. As Owen Potter there at the back.
gets overtaken by Jacob Metcalf. Oh! Owen Potter beans Metcalf into the wall.
Oh, Jacob's having an absolute mare here. Sam Wood looks to go for the move on Lewis Payton and is able to get that pass easily.
Jacob is out. I think he lost his front bumper after being binned in the wall.
Archie Heron has got past Jack Stewart and is now going to be on the push to catch up to Jake Fluitt. It is Jake Fluitt. And yeah, Jacob Metcalf has been fired from the rain. Unfortunately, a very, very upsetting way for him to go out, and that is just the worst look imaginable today.
And just looking at the replay, looked to be more of a mistake than anything. Not sure they could be much done about it.
Yeah, there's not really. They don't mind. There are mates as well there, so it's not quite the worst situation.
Exactly.
And now there is a lot of. There's an insane amount of pressure on Jake Fluitt right now from Archie Heron.
Archie Heron desperately trying to scramble through.
He's going to try his.
He's trying to go around the outside.
Down the inside of the first quarter. He's not going to be able to do that. Switches right behind. Is he going to go for a lunge here? No, he isn't. Is he going to wait?
Yes, he is.
He's going to go down the inside of the first part.
Down the inside. Beautiful.
That doesn't leave Jake Fluitt any space to come back at that. And now he's got about a second to make up on Alphonse Kivy, who doesn't have many laps left to hold on to this pre-final win.
Unless Alphonse can pick up the pace, I think that the back guys set from second to fourth will easily catch him.
The gap's only extended by about two. The gap's only closed by about 2/10. So at the moment, if because Jake Fluitt isn't getting off the back of Archie Heron. Archie Heron's got to think about being staying defensive. So there is actually a really strong chance here that Alphonse Kivy will be able to get away with this. Never mind, the gap is massively closed.
Yes, the gap is dropping very quickly.
Let's see. So Archie Heron looks like this is the penultimate lap now. Archie Heron within half a second. At his current rate of pace, he should be able to be either right on the back or even ahead of Alphonse Kivy by the end of this lap. It's not going to happen in this chicane.
And this is, of course, saying that Jake Fluitt does not go for a
move.
Fancy dive bomb.
Jack Stewart is also out of the race. I missed that.
Ooh.
Apologies. This race at the front is just so tight.
I think Alphonse is going to go for the move. Sorry, Heron's going to go for the move this lap.
Got it.
They will nudge down the straight.
Around the outside. He walked around the outside. He gets the switchback.
Oh.
Brilliant move. Switchback. Holds it into the chicane. Absolutely outstanding on the last lap for Archie Heron. Jake Fluitt looking around the outside. Is he going to be able to get a switch on him as well? No, he isn't.
No, he might be able to hold it down. Alphonse looks as if he's a little bit of contact that almost sent Alphonse spinning off.
And Jake not able to find it. It's a drag race to the line for P2.
Alphonse.
Oh, it is.
Alphonse second.
Wow. So tight.
That is a.
Sam Williams.
That is.
Heron wins the free final.
300.
Alphonse Kivy, Jake Fluitt, Logan Stewart, Sam Williams, Daniel Adamaiti, Lewis Payton, and Owen Potter round off the finishers. Unfortunately, we did lose Jack Stewart, Jacob Metcalf, and I believe. So we lost Jack Stewart, Jacob Metcalf, Radu Keenton, and Frederick Yannick from that race due to retirement and disqualifications. But an absolutely. A really challenging drive. Really challenging drive for Archie Heron with a bit of an incident near the start of the race. pushing him.
The one for five, Daniel Adamaiti, just looking like he's having a bit of fun on track as he comes in, as he's peeling into the pit lane. Okay. So to the viewers wondering why we're saying okay out of nowhere, we are just, we're being told what's happening with, what's going on with the replay that is.
So we're going to have Archie Heron. Hello, Archie.
Hello, Archie.
Wait, let me turn another stream. It's a very good stream, by the way.
Oh, thank you.
We did a thing.
We did a thing. So, you had a bit of an incident with Jake at the nearish the start. What happened?
So, coming out of the chicane, just was like with the physics, got a bit too close, so I swiped it. Not on purpose, but that's why I slowed down, coming round the outer edge of the top bend, so I could let him through, so I could get rid of the penalty, so he don't protest it and make both of us happy.
Seems like a bit of netcode there.
Yeah, and it was a good drive as well. How did you find it?
Very good drive.
Were you just able to find the pace as well at the end, just to be able to catch up to Alphonse and get them moved on the last lap with a brilliant switchback?
After qualifying, I looked at the pressures, so I realised the pressures were just a bit out of whack. So going into the heat, I made it so it came on later. As you saw, I got past Logan, then I caught right onto the back of Jake.
Yeah, it was Jake and Alphonse.
And then it caused that, after getting past Jake, I asked for him to push, he pushed me, and we got right on the back of Alphonse, and I got past him and drove 6 tenths down on the last lap.
Yeah, very good drive.
Very good fast lap. Last lap.
Thank you.
Alright, let's hope that you are able to continue up this good pace for Heat 2 and the final.
Yeah, thank you.
Good luck.
So that was our Heat 1 winner there, Archie Heron.
And pre-final 2 is just beginning now, as people will be leaking onto the grid from the pit lane. Generally, people like to come in later, because holding on the brakes for a extended amount of time is not fun.
I am at, I can't remember which race it was, but I accidentally pressed my push start button before the race started and I got disqualified. Not my proudest seller.
I think I've barely gotten away scot-free with this. Because I've always sat there in the just before the race starts, just with my foot held hard on the pedal, just to make sure I don't even like go an inch forward.
Not even gonna risk it.
Yeah. I used to rev the engine, but I've given up on that after seeing other people doing it and getting disqualified.
You gotta wait. Just sit there. It's an unfortunate game.
Yeah.
So let's run through our grid today. We're going down to Bradley Keaton, I believe. So Archie Heron will start from pole position alongside Jake Flewitt on the front row. Second row is Alphonse Kivy and Logan Stewart. Third row in P5, Sam Lloyd in the number 5 cart. P6, the number 145 of Daniel Adamaiti. P7 and 8 is Jake Metcalf and Owen Potter are coming together in the in Heat 1.
No, I think Jacob will be wishing for a better race this time around, because that first race was just frankly dreadful.
Yeah. And then in P9 is Frederick Yannick, who was not able to start the race after managing to get himself disqualified off the jump start. And then it is Jack Stewart, Sebastian Grund, Lewis Paynton and Bradley Keaton and Lucas Anderson as well rounding off the grid today. And so far, no disqualifications off the start, and we are going to be underway, no jump starts. Which is very good.
Very good, very good.
The 53 of Bradley Keaton isn't moving off the start.
Oh, dear.
Is Archie Heron... My game lagging out. Yeah, never mind. My game was lagging out then. Archie Heron just, like, wasn't moving. Like, I wasn't able to select this option, and I was like, what's going on? Has he not started?
Nah, it always happens.
Now we have 14 caps here in Heat 2, so some is improving off the start. And let's hope here for a clean race start. Nothing untoward happening because just kind of obvious.
Let us hope for just as good as a race for the lead and the back of the pack as we had in heat one.
Here we go. We come around the final corner and we now wait for
the acceleration point, which is just at the beginning of the grid, just after the pit lane exit. Coming around entrance to the exit to pit lane, here we go, and acceleration point, and they're off.
Much better start for Jake Fluitt. Is Archie Heron going to be able to defend?
Dreadful start for Heron.
Heron's going to be dropped down to second place. It looks like yes, he is. Almost came under pressure there from
just able to hold on to third there.
Logan Stewart, who makes a little bit of contact with.
Oh, that's a bit of contact on Fluitt from Heron. Oh, that's a flipper.
Lots of them are off. A lot of cuts are off. Who is that?
That was almost a flipper. I'm not sure who it was, but there was almost a flipper.
Lucas Anderson and flips on the first lap. That is so unfortunate for him to come around.
That's a massive shame.
And that looks like it's going to be an overtake. It's already going to be controversy in this race. But Jake Fluitt leads Archie Heron from Logan Stewart. Doesn't lead Archie Heron anymore. Archie Heron takes the move through the chicane. Brilliant battling. Here's the top. The top six are in.
Top six. Jacob Metcalf is having a bit of a better race than last time. He's chilling seventh and he's hoping to catch up to the rest
right
of the pack.
He is right on the back of him, and it's only.
Oh, look at this. Heron and Fluitt pulling away from the rest of the pack.
They seem to be the absolute class act today. It was an unfortunate situation that led him. Federer Yannick running at the back of the grid right now. No, Bradley Keaton running at the back.
Bradley Keaton very far back.
Yeah. Oh, and that's Jake Fluitt's around wide and makes contact with Alphonse Kivy. So that'll be a nose cone for Kivy. And invites Logan Stewart off into P2. So our Heat 1 winner, Daniel, comes on. Well, Heat 1 second place finisher comes under heavy pressure. And Daniel Almighty now gets passed as well.
This is a cracking race for Heron so far. We're only five laps in through it. He's pulling away at a pace. 1.2 seconds ahead of the man in second.
Looking over here, Sam Lloyd makes a little bit of a mistake, invites Jacob Metcalf alongside. And Metcalf takes a very aggressive move, and that actually hits off Sam Lloyd. Sam Lloyd ends up behind Lewis Payton, that is.
There will be words about this.
Archie Heron leads now by 1.3 seconds. And the battle seems to be between currently Alphonse Kivy and Daniel Adamaiti. Kivy gets that pass off pretty well. Logan Stewart's going to be looking around the hairpin here. Looking just for a gap. Anything that Jake Fluitt is going to give away here. But it doesn't seem...
Sorry about that. Hold on. Just looking at the slight I made on Ironpod's setup earlier. It looks like most people are only very similar setup, so sorry about that.
Alright. Logan Stewart still looking for a gap. Nothing to be found just yet. Looking back over at the pack behind him, Jacob Metcalf is gone down to three carts now.
Archie Heron still pulling away every lap.
And Kivy takes hold P4 for now over Daniel Adamaiti. Logan Stewart still not able to find the position.
He's getting closer and closer every lap, and I think he's gonna try this lap.
Wasn't able to find the move into the first hairpin. To the chicane, are they gonna find any room? No, they're not. Daniel Adamaiti looks for a gap on Alphonse Kivy back in the fight for P4.
Ooh, little tap there. Little tap from Logan Stewart and Fluitt. Almost sent Fluitt into a little spin, but Fluitt held it, and they are going down the straight again, tucking, and Fluitt's pulled away a little bit, actually.
Oh, and Potter as well. Pushing Sebastian Grund. Is that pushing? Yes, but pushing Sebastian Grund all the way around here now into the first corner. Back here for the battle for P9. I think Potter's playing on a controller, if I'm not wrong. Which is impressive that he's. Is he not?
I'm not sure, but for those of you who have never played this game on controller, it is agony.
I haven't tried it on controller, to be fair. I know people have played it on controller, played on keyboard, which is even scarier. Jake Floyd, being able to make a gap. The battle rages on. Jacob Metcalf now right with Kivy and Adamaiti, and Metcalf not able to get past that.
Yeah, the battle is now.
Oh, and Kivy runs wide on
Mighty. There from Adamaiti. Kivy going back. Oh, Jacob. Oh,
Jacob, what on earth is that push there? Quite an aggressive move, attempt of a move. Nothing major from it, except I think that's Kivy who's going to be running wide, and Kivy's off. Kivy's been taken out by not by Samuel. Who took Kivy off? No, someone else did as well. Probably went off.
I feel like Jacob is not gonna be happy boy.
Potter now still down at P10 with Payton is coming under pressure from Grund. Last lap though, Archie Heron leads by 2.5 seconds.
Blewett, another second ahead of Stewart, and Jacob is a full.
This battle here. So, Metcalf. Behind. No, that's not battle there.
Heron going off again.
Archie Heron run wide. And unless Jake Blewett through. Blewett going into the last corner. And, where's Heron going to finish here? Heron's coming under pressure now from Logan Stewart.
Oh, that's a 53 out. Stewart's off. She's gone.
What happened? Yeah, that's fluid assault. I'm believing you came into contact with. No way. I think Bradley Keaton has crashed into the leaders here. And then's retired.
Oh, that is gonna. That is gonna cause.
Archie Heron.
Serious anger.
But that is enormous, as that means that Jake Fluitt, who almost managed to win that at the end.
Right, let me have a little look at this replay.
Wow. Contrast.
That's not going to make... that is not going to make anyone very happy.
I hope that was caught on the stream as well. I didn't see what happened.
Oh, he hit Archie Heron earlier in the lap anyway. That's what sent Heron off. A little collision with Bradley Keaton. Looks Bradley Keaton's trying to fight it. Oh no, Bradley Keaton just sent it off into the grass and was accidentally parked on the racing line. And yeah, no. Fluitt had to take evasive maneuvers on around the outside, went onto the grass, smashed it into a wall.
Alright.
Hello, Archie. Interview number two.
Yeah, you're right.
Yeah, not bad. What happened to the end? Because I didn't catch it.
I was trying to go on the move on... who is it again? I think...
I'm Bradley Keaton. I've had a look at the replay. He was trying to fight you, and then you're trying to lap him.
Yeah, I was up. But, I was really confused when he started, jolting around. I feel like he's driving on a controller, but he didn't have, spatial awareness. Like most people do, but
yeah,
I was lucky at the end from Jake Fleur. I think overcorrected something like I did, and they both got passed. But then I got back because of something really, really lucky.
Yeah. So I'm just watching over now, trying to figure out what happened. Recall what happened to Jake. Oh wow, yeah. Oh yeah, it was just off track. That's unfortunate.
Yeah. Unfortunately, not much to be done about that, but you got the win, though.
Yeah, yeah. That's the main thing. Even though it's not for the championship, the main thing is, like, starts pole for the final. Just see if we can get a good start and just drive off.
Yeah,
and the E-plate is a nice one to have.
Well, we've got to do that. Got to have it 2 seasons in a row.
No, you want to last it with my hand?
Oh.
You're trying to get every plate you can. O plate, yeah. E plate, SE plate, and the one plate.
Yeah, hopefully I can, win the last round to get the one plate again. Because I think it's only like 3 points separating us.
That is close.
But then the open. Oh, yeah, got the race, haven't we?
Three finals started. Good luck.
Good luck. Right, results team.
Welcome back, everyone.
Hello, everybody.
Welcome back to the final of the kart virtual e-plate at Clay Pigeon. I'll quickly run you through the starting grid. Front row is Archie Heron and Logan Stewart this time, after a very late issue for Jake Fluitt, who is starting from the back of the grid today. Second row is Sam Lloyd and Jacob Metcalf, followed by Daniel Adamaiti and Sebastian Grond. 7th and 8th respectively is for Owen Potter and Alphonse Kivy. Lewis Paynton and Jack Stewart in P9 and P10. 11th and 12th, Fedor Yannick and Jake Fluitt. And the only DNF, I believe, of the last race, or one of two, is Lucas Antonen running at the back of the grid. And as I've done that, we are coming across now to the start-finish line. It's a good start for Logan Stewart. He's going to be able to take the lead. Is he in his contact already? And that's the 1.45 of Daniel Adamaiti off. Logan Stewart, though, able to fight and take the lead of the race. Hit. Archie Heron is going to have to do a little bit of defensive work on Sam Lloyd.
Jacob Metcalf has made good positions, though.
Nice.
In fourth.
Luke Samson has made it further in this race. He's actually running currently up 2 places, I believe, that is, ahead of Jack Stewart and Jake Fluitt is really pushing, it would seem. He's already up into P7. Brilliant start for him.
Oh, Heron almost lost it. Jake gives him a little bit of a bump.
Really trying.
Oh, Heron down the inside. Heron. Down inside. Oh, he's getting. He's got it.
That's a lead. No. Logan Stewart has made contact.
Logan Stewart spun. Oh, and that is Owen off. Owen Potter's gone.
Owen Potter was off there with Sebastian.
There was someone else with him, but I couldn't quite tell who it was. You've now got Lewis Payton right behind Metcalf.
Heron takes the lead for the race again here. Could he be on for a complete clean sweep of the E-fight here?
Yeah,
Sam Lloyd's gonna...
I'm not sure...
Sam Lloyd's best to say otherwise, though.
Oh, yeah. I'm not sure we've ever had a clean sweeping car, but... Oh, no, we have. We have one before.
Oh, yeah.
So it'll be our second ever clean sweep we've ever had in this series.
That'll be outstanding. Mm-hmm. And now, looking further back the grid, Lewis Payton... Lewis Payton putting Jacob Metcalf into heavy pressure here. Metcalf just trying to extend the gap. The gap is about 0.2 seconds. The gaps are already beginning to form slightly as drivers are trying just to stay out of trouble. It's been quite a difficult one. Daniel Adamaiti, who is going to be really disappointed here, running currently at the back of the grid. Coming into issues own Potter as well, running at the back, expecting gone.
Shame actually, because I'm pretty sure Adamaiti had an okay qualifying actually.
Yeah, it's disappointing. It's going to be disappointing for him. It's not up. I don't think it was his mistake as
Sam,
well.
Sam Lloyd. Jake Fluitt straight down the inside of Kivi. No questions asked. On the straight.
Jake Fluitt with an outstanding start, getting from the back of the grid up to P3 in the first few laps of the race here.
Oh yeah, no, that's amazing.
Alphonse Kivi's going to try and fight back though to get that position back. He will very much be wanting to get a podium here. But he is unable to so far.
And I think, if I'm right, just looking at that, Jake Fluitt is pulling away slightly from Kivi.
That is a really good start for Fluitt.
Oh, yeah, amazing start.
Sam Lloyd is not able to keep up the pace of Archie Heron right now, so this race is really playing into his hands. Jack Stewart, though, and Frederick Yannick seem to be in a titanic battle. No, that's, There's Frederick Yannick not able, and Jack Stewart runs wide.
Runs wide.
That brings Yannick.
He's let one through.
That's two through. As Owen
two through.
As well. And I'll possibly make a little
bit.
That
was almost
three
through.
Wow.
That was almost three.
All over here, Owen Potter. Not able to keep up Frederick Yannick's pace as it seems, as Yannick extends the gap ever so slightly.
Metcalf just seems to be in a bit of a race of his own right now.
Metcalf enjoying a nice little bit of space as well in P5.
Sunday drive.
Right at the back, Adamaiti has managed to get past Jack Stewart. Jack Stewart now under pressure from Sebastian Grand at the back of the grid.
Oh, look at that,
Jake
Logan Blewett. Stewart.
Alphonse Kibbe's gonna. Who's that? No. Sam Lloyd is. No, that's an imposter, even. Trying to watch back now at Alphonse Kivi, my cameras weren't doing camera things. A minute there.
Man does that as well.
It's so frustrating. Nothing we can really do about it.
Yeah.
But Alphonse Kivi is going to try and find a way past here as they have really caught up to Sam Lloyd as well. So this is now more of a battle for P2 than it is for P1, unfortunately. As Archie Heron's pace is just absolutely dominant in this final.
But no one has been anywhere near him. He is just...
Sam Lloyd gives the thumbs up and Lloyd goes down the inside. Makes a little bit of contact with Lloyd and that brings Alphonse Kivi as well up a position into P3. Sam Lloyd down to P4. Alphonse Kivi goes down the inside of Jake Fluitt. They're unable to find the position though.
Poor Sam, he's just lost a ton of positions corner.
Jake Fluitt points forward, almost to say, let's work together here. It's not a battle that we need to fight. It's a battle that we need to catch up to Archie Heron.
I would have said it's too late, but they've still got 6 laps left. I think if they work together, they might just be able to do it. Oh, Jake Fluitt's breaking later than Alphonse Kivi there, because under the brakes, Alphonse dropped probably like a tenth or two.
There's absolutely nothing separating them as well with the different styles, however. Rodan at the back of Rodan looking at the back of the grid. Daniel Adamaiti is now a lap down as Archie Herring, I believe, goes past.
This is not what Adamaiti would have hoped for.
Deacon Metcalf going, having to defend from Logan Stewart. Logan Stewart gets the switch back. Brilliant move. Can Jacob Holt cover it? Cuts the corner, crashes.
Oh, they're both out.
Oh, that is not the politest.
Yeah, Logan Stewart. Not only did he lose a pod, but he's also out.
To retire. I'm guessing Jacob Metcalf.
I think Jacob's going to get some naughty boy points for today. Oh, and he just spun someone else out.
1-4-5, Daniel Adamaiti, who he was lapping, to be fair. So that is bad driving from Adamaiti.
I think Jacob's getting naughty boy points today.
Going to be a big penalty handed out. That's 250 of Alphonse Kivy. Still right on the back of RG Heron. I don't think Alphonse is paying attention to RG trying to say work together. He's more thinking that 3 second gap is almost insurmountable.
And with the gap that big, it's completely fair.
They have extended
They did just close in about two tenths there actually.
I like Daniel Adamaitis is Oh, messages in the chat, by the way.
Oh god, there's more.
I think he's got his opinion across there. We're not going to say what it is over the stream, but let's just say he is not very happy.
Oh yeah, no. Hey, Jacob retired.
That is probably the right move. We don't know what's happened, but whatever it is, it's not a fortunate scenario.
It's a big shame for Jacob as well, because he was hoping for big points today, because he's generally quite good around here.
Although it is still holding on for dear life on this gargantuan attack from Alphonse Kivy, who is just biding his time, waiting and waiting and waiting as well.
Kivy will be looking for any mistake.
Oh, wow. Daniel Adamaitis has been rejected, and I believe is disqualified from the race meet.
Ooh, so Adamaitis has... That would be for the kind messages in chat.
That could be... very, very big ban, or very unfortunate situation that we don't want to have to deal with.
Oh yeah.
RG Heron then absolutely sheerly dominant in this race. Brilliant work.
I feel like Adamaiti might be having a couple words.
And here we go, final lap. Archie Heron is gonna lead us away here, but. In other words, Kivy goes down the inside of Fluitt and takes.
And that is what Kivy was waiting for.
And Fluitt is going to have to come right back at him. And he's finally, patience has been rewarded. But now, as Jake Fluitt does not have time to afford to be patient, he has to go for it. Something absolutely spectacular has moved. Has to occur now.
I think that was exactly what Kivy was waiting for.
Archie Heron comes across the line to win the E-plate. In car virtual
clean sweep. Fluitt looked down the inside, trying grab second place.
P2. Sam Lloyd P4. Lucas Antonen out of nowhere has come P5.
Thumbs up from Jake Fluitt, not returned by Kivy.
Aaron Potter P8. Jack Stewart P9. Sebastian Grund has come to a standstill on the line. Is he going to be able to finish the race? No, he isn't. That is so unfortunate. My game's crashed.
I will take over commentary from here. Yeah, so Grond has not been able to finish the race after that unfortunate bit. But Kivy not returning thumbs up back after the race. No congratulatory and good race thumbs up. But did put in chat good race. So clearly it's still sportsmanship between them. So, absolutely amazing clean sweep from Heron, 4 seconds ahead of the rest of the pack. It's just, we haven't really seen much like this in Kart Virtual before. It's very good though. And I think, if I'm right, we will be dragging Heron into here for an interview. And look at that, Gron's trying to give his car a little push to the line.
That is so unlucky for him.
Hello, Aussie, Aaron.
Clean sweep there. Congrats, man.
Oh, fuck you.
That's got to be one of the... I think that's like one of only two clean sweeps we've ever had, isn't it?
I did. Wow. I think in the main championship, I did it here as well.
Wow.
You clearly like the circuit then.
It's one of my strong circuits on this game.
Yeah, it's a good...
Is it one of your strong circuits in real life, though?
No. I don't like it in real life.
Oh, God, no, I hate it.
But, like, I think last time I drove it was in Cadet, but usually I drive... Well, I'm not going to go down in, like, some Senior X and just drive it, because it just wouldn't be the same.
Yeah.
Yeah, right. No, not the same. You know, clean sweep, amazing race, 4 second gap from Kivi. How are you feeling about your championship fight now? Because you were right about that. You were only 3 points behind. And I think with that, just let me have a quick check of the... with Lewis Gordon. Yeah, that should put you into the leader championship.
No, but like it makes you feel a bit more confident going into the final round, you know? Because as Lewis is in my team and all, like I do make the setups as I realize in this race, like even though I overfueled, I still just kept the consistent gap once I saw like 2 seconds from Sam Lloyd. So I just kept on pushing to the point where I just didn't get any, like, I didn't cut any of the corners or anything, so I can definitely confirm the win. But I've got to wait until results get posted.
If you're looking at the replay right now, you can see Grond is still trying to push his cart towards the line.
Is he actually?
Yeah, he's trying to do it.
Fair enough.
That's what I was cracking.
He's almost there.
Oh, commitment.
Come on. Grond, there's another button you can press and you got a lot quicker.
Oh, yeah, to be fair. As long as his engine's shut off, just press P. So much faster.
Yeah. But yeah, that was an amazing race from you today.
I weren't expecting it, because, like, Jake put a really good fight. Over the first 2 seasons I saw him race, he's improved quite... like a bit, so he's quite a guy. It's quite a good person to race now because he has good race craft.
Yeah, he's good.
Oh, I haven't improved one, but he did it. He crossed the line. Good dedication from Grond.
Determination. It's a lesson you should learn. Always have dedication.
Very good.
Pro tip for every if you ever get out of a race, just continue driving. More fun that way.
Anyway.
You know, genuinely, amazing drive today. Yeah, and congratulations with the
E-plate.
Oh my god. Having an absolute bender today, Jesus.
Oh well. Still, it's a plate. I've kept the plate 2 seasons in a row.
Yeah, very well good. Done,
and are you gonna wear the E-plate for the final round, or are you gonna keep the one on?
Oh, I don't know. I might have to go ask the person who made my paint to quickly go put it on there so I can run it. But, oh well.
Jay
in the, oh my god. Jay in the comments. I haven't even paid attention to it in the chat.
Oh no, there's comments still.
Jacob. Jacob's going
Jacob.
On.
Not even... No. I've
got no drop down.
No drop down.
Yeah, you're good.
Yeah, sounds good.
Anyway, congrats, man.
Thanks.
Yeah, congrats.
We'll catch you in the next race as well.
Oh, what, you're streaming last race as well? Sounds good.
I don't know, yeah. We'll try to.
Hopefully.
Yeah.
If we can.
Yeah. Finn, are you looking forward to the OKL World Finals? Because I've got... have got actually put something into it.
Yeah, I'm looking into that. I'm really. Yeah. But I will also like stream it. So, I will see where you go. You are my little my provisional banana.
Yeah.
Yeah, oh, yeah. Wait a minute. We might be commentating on OKL World Final.
That'd be good. Cause like, but the thing is, right, I need to put out here now. I'm actually looking for drivers for it.
I'll drive.
Need drivers. I've got a great setup. Currently fourth on the leaderboard of lap times. So
I'll drive. I desperately need a setup.
To be fair. Awesome.
Yeah, so if anyone's looking, just send me a Discord message or something.
All right.
Yeah.
We'll see you. See you guys.
Have fun.
Next race.
Bye.
Yeah. Bye. Good job.
Thanks.